Hey guys, I want to take a second to address a question I get fairly frequently, which has to do with how scientists get paid. So I'm going to give you a quick rundown, but again, I have to preface this by saying this is just one person, an American, who is a researcher who works in academia, so through universities. So there are various other perspectives you might get that might deviate from what I'm about to say, but I'll try to give you kind of a general lay of the land. But again, my perspective is mostly from the academic environment. So generally, scientists' research gets funded by grants. We've talked about that briefly in other videos. But it is also often true that salaries are covered at least in part by grants. And you have kind of both ends of the spectrum in the science world. You have some scientists who rely, their salary is reliant entirely on grants that they are awarded. And this can be a stressful position to be in because grants aren't always awarded. And if you require those for your salary, that means you might not get paid sometimes. And then there's all the way to the other end of the spectrum. There are researchers who their salary does not depend at all on grants. They get a salary 12 months out of the year, and grants just cover research expenses or supplement that salary. So you kind of get both ends of the spectrum. In traditional academic institutions in the United States, it's not uncommon at all for it to be kind of a hybrid between those two. Most often, in my experience, it's 9 months of salary paid by the university, that's your employer, and then you're responsible for a summer salary, essentially. 3 months of salary that you would fund through grants. So you'd apply for grants through the federal government, through various agencies, nonprofits, private foundations, and I'll get into that a little bit more in other videos, but those are the ways you can get grants, and these grants can occupy various amounts of your salary. So it is true, loud birds interrupting the video, pretty cool though. It is true that if you are paying federal taxes in the United States, those taxes are funding yes, research, and often the salaries of scientists. Just making sure that these scientists can stay alive while they conduct the research that is, you know, meant to help society, both domestically and abroad. So it is a little bit of a different pay model than a lot of people are used to, because there is this sort of element of chance that's there. You could go, in theory, without pay for a while if you are unable to get grants. And this is one of the reasons that I am such an advocate for funding of science, because obviously it's in my best interest to remain paid so that I continue to be able to focus my efforts on developing new research that will improve how we understand our world. And this, I think, is, and you ask any scientist, I think they'll say, generally, yes, grant money is essential to keep this whole thing going. Of course, we need our research funded, but before we even need our research funded, we need to be able to feed ourselves. And so a lot of that can come from grants. And when researchers work for governments, so various levels of government, municipal, state, federal in the United States, or federal in other countries, their salaries are often paid entirely through taxation. So that's another way that, again, you, the people, are instrumental in keeping not only science going, but scientists going. We are essentially public servants whose job is to expand human knowledge for the betterment of society as a whole. So hopefully that gives you a little bit of a better idea on where science money, rather, where the income of scientists comes from. And I will do some follow-up videos to talk more deeply about how grants work and how we fund our research specifically, what the process is like to apply for these grants and compete, in some cases very intensively, to get the funding to do the research that hopefully is successful and improves our understanding of the world and in turn, how we're able to persist in that world. So I'll leave you with that, and more videos coming soon.